Let me share a story I imagined about shapes outdoors. There is an animal flying with two big wings way up there in the sky. I'm wondering about the wings. Will you wonder with me? What shape do the wings of this bird remind you of? Perhaps a circle that goes round and round? Or maybe a triangle with one, two, three sides meeting at one, two, three corners. What shape do the wings on the bird's body remind you of? Show someone next to you your arms. If they were wings, what shape would they be? Fly, fly, fly to reach the sky. And as you look closer, notice that each wing is not round at all. It has three sides and three corners, making the shape of a triangle. Wait! Now, I notice more triangles on the bird's body. Do you notice that too? How many triangles do you notice on the bird's body? And how are they the same or different compared to the triangular wings? Let me see if I found all the triangles that you found. The beak now. The beak also reminds me of a triangle that looks almost the same as the wings, but smaller. How about the head? Oh, the head also reminds me of a triangle that looks almost the same as the beak, but triangles did I find? How many did you find? Wow! The triangular wings move the bird's body. And the movement reminds me of circles and circles and circles in the air. It's so much fun to draw what we notice, isn't it? Feel free to get a piece of paper and something you use to draw. What shapes would you draw that you see around you? Press pause and come back to the story when you're ready. Is circling above this dirt road. It hasn't been raining for a while. The soil is getting so dry that it's forming cracks and cracks and cracks along the way. Will you wonder about the shape of the cracks with me? Do they look like a triangle? Or more like a circle? What do we remember about the sides and corners of the triangle? Tell someone next to you. How about the circle? The cracks go around and around. Look at them. No sides, no corners. The cracks on the dirt road are shaped like circles. And the bird is still circling above the dirt road. This particular circular movement gives a clue that the bird is hungry and it is searching for its prey, which is an animal to eat. I noticed the shape of its beak. Look at it. The curved shape of its beak helps it tear off the meat of an animal into smaller pieces. Yeah, the shape of its beak is a clue that this bird is a carnivore, which means that it eats meat instead of plants and seeds. It is still flying above the dirt road when it notices an animal right below it. The dirt road is long, and this animal is long, but not as long as the dirt road. This animal is moving without any legs on the dirt road. Its muscles and round scales covering its body help it move. I wonder what this animal reminds you of. It's a snake. The bird is getting hungrier. If you were the snake, how would you escape from getting eaten by the bird? Keep moving, snake! Faster and faster and faster! The snake needs a place to hide under. We would hide under something that is shaped like a circle? Or perhaps a triangle. Or maybe another shape. What shapes do snakes make with their bodies? Feel free to draw what you think. Take your time. The story is going to end with the snake hiding under a shape that covers its whole body when it's all curled up. Look at your drawing. If you decide to change the shape of your drawing to hide a snake that is all curled up like a ball, it's fine. I'm just curious what you were thinking of that made you change your mind. It's also fine if you decide to leave your drawing the way it was. I'm just curious, what made you not want to change it? Thank you so much for protecting the snake from the bird of prey. I'm sorry, bird. You will need to find something else to eat at this time. And I'm wondering what it will find. Will you wander with someone as you create your own stories because really, stories should never end. Have fun, my friends.